Hello, dear friends. Here we are, moment of harmony with Euripides Barsanulfo, the medium of Jesus, bringing to us an opportunity to revisit our state of mind, our feelings, and recalibrate ourselves. We're all in the same journey. On the earth, we are together in this beautiful opportunity of growing. And awareness is keyword. It's keyword to progress. We cannot remodel a house without being fully aware of what to remodel. We cannot transform ourselves without knowing what to transform, where to begin, and how to do it. Transformation at human being level happens through awareness. We need to be aware. That's the main difference between us and the animal kingdom, plus our free will. Because we are aware, we can choose, making choices based on our new consciousness, new level of consciousness, shall be transformative. So we are here with Euripides Barsanulfo tonight or today, depending on when you're listening to this and where. We are here to learn about the different signs of spiritual stagnation. Before we read his message, we would like to revisit a question that Allan Kardec asked the spirits, and he published in the spirits book together with the answer of these educating minds. Can we regress as spirits? And the answer is no. We never regress. We always progress. But we may delay our progress. We may stay at that level, stagnated for a while, because the pace of our progress is dictated by ourselves. God allows it, but we never regress. So these are good news, right? The good news, you don't regress, nobody regresses. So if there is anybody in this world nowadays who is at any moment saying, oh, the world is getting worse, don't believe them. Don't believe them. Throughout humankind's history, we're evolving. That's evident. The only thing is that now we know exactly what's happening everywhere else in the world. And the difference between good and evil is becoming quite evident. No longer things are masked. Everything is being revealed. Nobody can pretend to be who they are not. Everything is being open. All the secrets are being revealed. And it's happening also inside of each one of us. And it's a good moment to create new harmony, to calibrate ourselves with the divine harmony. After all, there is nothing more important in this world than God. Nothing. And this is not a dogmatic view. It's actually a reasoned faith, right, friends? G-O-D, God is here. G-O-D, God is everywhere. God is literally everywhere. Everywhere. Inside and out and everywhere. And we shall use our days to fulfill God's will on earth, as it already is in heaven. That's the first exercise for the next 24 hours. Are we dedicating our thoughts, feelings, words, actions to God? That's the true practice of the law of worship. When we dedicate our lives in its fullness to God, and it shall be transformed. right? So let us read. Visualize. Let's visualize ourselves in a beautiful classroom. And Professor Euripides Barsanulfo, as the educator, leading this class, telling us this lesson about our ascension. Let us see what he says. Brothers and sisters, may the Master cover us in his divine love. Let us seek the peace of our hearts so that we may distribute harmonies to our fellow beings. Let us heed to the imperatives of understanding so that the resources of serenity visit us in moments of difficulties. Let us look for the elements of justice in the safe box of our hearts so that our neighbor may be beneficially influenced by us. Let us seek tirelessly, with tireless attention, the weaknesses that are dormant in our inner world, lest we will not be surprised in dangerous situations. Let us contemplate the marvelous work of divine love so that we may withdraw from it the guiding lesson, may draw from it the guiding lesson. The guiding lessons of our path. The strict fulfillment of the duties before the Father and human beings leads us to the conquest of inner peace. The practice of justice in all sectors of our activities solves the great problem of divine things. Justice manifests itself in the persevering exercise of the good through the great law that expresses itself. Do not do to others what you do not desire for yourself, or do to your neighbor what you wish for yourselves. The spirits of the Lord never get tired of extending protective hands to earthly individuals. They are like the sun that offers the life of its rays to all. Good and evil individuals receive the permanent incentives of Jesus, and they have always received them through the ages and civilizations. How much longer will humanity sleep in indifference regarding the issues of the spirit? How much longer will humanity want to suffer the consequences of their mistakes? Awaken, my dear siblings, for the experiences and the lights of understanding have already visited your spirits in the great trajectories of successive lives. You have already taken the first step. To stop will be criminal regret. And how many times have you interrupted your steps on the ascending path of a day? Every time you forget the great lesson of illumination of your mouth by the good word, you surrender yourself to the shadows of slander. Whenever you vibrate in thoughts of intolerance before the incomprehensible brother, you mark your path with a dangerous stake. When you do not allow your weaknesses to be pointed out, giving freedom to your pride, you are allowing the virus of stagnation to dwell in your spirit. May Jesus protect our hearts in the necessary strengthening to the true ascent. Euripides Barsanulfo, on May 30th, 1955. What is beautiful about this is that he repeats throughout the message when we analyze it. Some of the key words are based on understanding. understanding. So we need to boost that understanding. And to work on understanding, we need to make a choice. Make a choice. It's our choice to be understanding or not regarding ourselves and others. It's up to us. But that's a decision. It begins in a decision. When we're meeting somebody and somebody says, "Oh, my life is terrible," usually people are like, "Oh my God, here they come again. Here they come." But what about making a choice? I want to be of help. So I'm going to share with all of you a tip that Emmanuel gave to Chico Xavier. He said, "In life, Chico, there are two types of people that you're going to encounter. People through whom you're going to learn, and people through whom you're going to serve. In either or, you need to boost your understanding to figure out, am I here to learn from this person or am I here to serve?" Of course, we can dispute philosophically, but we won't, because we respect the wisdom of Emmanuel. But we could dispute like, "Oh, but when we're serving or learning." But what he meant as an educator is that we need to be humble, to recognize that first, we are learning beings. We need to boost that inside of us every day. Often we look at children and we think, they need to learn, they need to learn, they need to learn. And then we grow up, we shut down the learning doors. Open the gates of learning, shall we? Let's open. So tonight we have the key. Ping. Sharing with you, you and I, a key, the key of understanding. That's what Euripides Barsanov is telling us. Rescuing from Emmanuel to it matches the key of understanding. So, first choice, what am I doing here now? You're going to Starbucks, or you're going to the grocery shopping, or stopping by at your work, to work, or to your college, or you're going to high school. Doesn't matter where you are. In every scenario, what am I here to learn? And how can I be of service? But first, learn. Because that's where we get ourselves in trouble. We shut down the gates of learning, and then we'll go straight to what he says, the stagnation. He says, when we do not allow our weaknesses to be pointed out, giving freedom to your pride, you're allowing the virus of stagnation to dwell in your spirit. Mm-hmm. It's when I say, "I already know it. I don't need to. I know. I know. I know." Let's erase that from us. We don't know many things. We don't know, and that's fantastic. It doesn't depress me. Does that depress you? When you think you have a lot to learn? It's actually exciting to know that I'm going to wake up every day and it's on me to grasp the lessons. How many students are in a classroom? The teachers are trying to teach and the students are closed off. They don't want to learn. So the lesson, in order to be learned, doesn't need a teacher. It needs the openness of the student. So if I am open, I will learn. So that's the exercise in the next 24 hours. Let us be open to the learning everywhere we are, everywhere we go. Ask, what can I learn here? Thinking about spiritual evolution. That's why Professor Euripides Barsanov is saying we can no longer sleep in indifference regarding the issues of spirit. No longer. even us. And I say even us, because sometimes we say, I believe in spirits, I believe in evolution, I believe in God, many lives, but in our daily lives, we behave in a completely incoherent way. We behave not like immortal spirits living on earth. Mm-hmm. We behave like bodies living on earth, attempting to be in immortality in this body. It's not going to happen. I know many spirits, if you tell them about death, they're like, oh my God. No, 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 but death can happen at any time. Big deal. Death is not bad. God didn't create that door back to the spiritual realm to punish us. On the contrary, it's graduation if we have fulfilled it. But it's on God to tell us whether we are right or wrong. Let us rewind the tape, because he's talking about slander here, and he says, how many times have you interrupted your steps on the ascending path? He gives us three scenarios. One, every time we forget that we need to use our words wisely, regarding ourselves as well. Do you often tell bad things about yourself? Please don't. No, 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 no. We can't. Emmanuel, in the book Living Spring, chapter 151. And I will repeat it, because when I read it this past Tuesday, I was quite impressed. I've read it before, but I didn't pay attention to this. And I think that's very transformative when Emmanuel says, the minute we speak ill of anyone, including ourselves, we renounce the title of co-workers of God to become critics of God's works. So today we cannot stagnate in our evolution anymore and speak ill of ourselves. I know people, they meet you and they say, nice to meet you. By the way, I have this problem. So, what's the point? That person is not your judge. Love God above all things and people. And love others as you love yourself. If somebody tells me that, my conclusion is that person doesn't love God, doesn't love themselves, and of course doesn't love me either. They're just afraid. They are afraid of their own conscience. And they think by talking about it out loud, they're controlling that fear, and it's just getting worse. So Euripides Barsanuvo says, we stagnate, we interrupt our steps in our ascension when we speak ill of anyone. That would solve a lot of problems overnight on the earth. Two, whenever we vibrate thoughts of intolerance, we mark our path with dangerous stake. And that's exactly what's happening to our world nowadays. We're living at a time of extreme aggressiveness and intolerance. We can't. As Martin Luther King Jr. said, we won't drive out evil with evil. So we need to learn what he says, Euripides Barsanuvo. Understanding. Let's heed to the imperatives of understanding, so that the resources of serenity visit us in moments of difficulty. Serenity. Understanding that generates serenity. When I enter a psychiatric hospital, I need to enter with understanding, or I won't bring serenity. They are sick. Life is like this. A big hospital on the earth, a big prison, a big school. We're here learning, overcoming our illnesses of the spirit, and at the same time, imprisoned in our own limitations. So more than ever, we realize we need understanding. Understand ourselves. Bless your pathway. Look at yourself in the mirror. Let's look at ourselves in the mirror and say, God allowed me to make choices. If God allowed me to make choices, how come I don't understand myself? Nowadays, I know better. No wonder Jesus said the ultimate understanding statement. God forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. Jesus only concluded it after he, of course, understood the scenario. He knew it. He understood it. That's why he remained serene. Understand that we're all learning, all progressing. And finally, Ulrich Pérez Barçanufo says, the third scenario when we interrupt our progress is when we don't want people to tell our weaknesses, point them out, or when we don't want to point them out ourselves, thinking, I'm a genius, I'm the greatest, etc. That is lack of humility, and we cannot progress without it. Humility is not telling people on a Facebook post, oh, I'm so impatient. That's lack of self-love. Because these are statements we don't disclose publicly like that, unless we have hurt people publicly, collectively, then it would be appropriate to say, I'm so sorry. But if it's your thing, it's a particular and private thing, don't open that, because that's lack of self-love. And Professor Ripitz Barçanufo is telling us, let's rest assured that the good spirits, the spirits of the Lord, never get tired of extending their protective hands towards us on the earth. And that's the analogy. They are like the sun that offers the life of its rays to all. The sun that offers the life of its rays to all. Literally, we know that the team of the Christ spirits in our solar system meet on the sun, and their pure rays, pure thoughts, radiate light that gives life. Literally, it's in a footnote of the Spirit's Book by Kardec, and Euripides Barçanufo is just reinforcing the concept. So visualize yourself, the sun of the pure thoughts and feelings of the spirits radiating towards you, supporting you. Next time you see the sun, feel the pure and loving thoughts and feelings of the spirits bathing you in life, in love, in new protection. He says that no matter if we're doing good or not, we permanently receive the help of Jesus. Always. Jesus never gives up on us. Whether we make a wise decision or not. So the homework for us, draw, okay? Artistic. Take a piece of paper. It could ideally color pencil, crayons, could be paint if you want. Draw the sun, thinking about the pure spirits that meet on the sun, and they are radiating their light. And draw yourself in that scenario. Where are you in that paper? Draw yourself there and visualize yourself on the earth. And if you're not a good artist, don't worry. You can draw the little, you know, the little circle, just like myself, I would do it, right? Or like a cookie man, and visualizing the sun rays of light bathing you. That's our homework in the next 24 hours, right, sunshine? The sun is God's eye. Okay, friends, let's do the exercise artistically, because when we use the right brain, we are skipping the rationalization of the left hemisphere, and thus we're feeling more of the scriptures, okay? And visualize yourself ascending always, because after all, you know it. You are a child of God. Visualize yourself on the earth. You are a child of God. You've reincarnated to learn to do good and to do good. Right? Reincarnation, the path of progress. Can I feel the sun through the window? Too cold outside. Of course, Livia Moraes. Of course, Livia Moraes. By the way, for those who are still willing to join Reincarnation 101 on this Sunday, we have a private YouTube link. We're not going to open wide for several purposes, but we'll share with those who want to do the course from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're going to be working on Reincarnation 101, a book that was put together by Luis Hu, and we will be working on it through mini lectures and activities to feel the scriptures, okay, this Sunday. And another announcement I cannot forget is the campaign for the symposium on April 21st. Go to spiritsymposium.org. Do your registration. It's just something not to miss. I wouldn't miss it in a million years. If God is willing, I would be there. Okay? If that matches God's will, I'll be there. But you should be there too. And the other thing is, you can win a hotel accommodation for 2 nights. We're giving that away for two people who make a video of the upcoming International Spiritist Youth event on July 7 and 8. You just make a video announcing the event, however you want to do it. Send it to us on April 3rd. We're going to be announcing the winners of the hotel accommodations in Washington, D.C. Right, Souza? How about that? Right, Rudy, sunshine shining on us, right? So, Teresa Castro, exactly. Thank you so much. So, friends, don't forget the sun. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mrs. Sun, please shine down on me. And they do. Oh, Mr. Sun, sun, Mr. Golden Sun. They don't hide behind the tree, right? These little children are asking you, please come out and we can play with you. Mr. Sun, Sun, Mr. Golden Sun, please shine down on us. Okay? So that's the spirit. Nina, I will send you the link as well, okay? So I forgot. Everybody send cardiacradio@gmail.com. Any mail requesting the link, we'll send you the link so you can join us on Sunday, 10 a.m. Washington, D.C. time. The sun is female in German. Hallelujah. Thank you so much, Sunshine. Friends, a super big hug to each one of you who so faithfully joined forces, right, Adilson? Big super hug to you. You deserve to be happy. Sunshine, Lea Severo, how are you? Aline, how are you? Teresa Catapano, how are you? La Souza, how are you? Nora Brasil, Cessa, beautiful Cessa, how are you? Teresa Castro, Giovanna Souza, Narciso the Light Man, how are you? Joyce Magalhães, beautiful mother, God bless you. Celia Lancaster, how are you? Julie, beautiful Australia, how are you? Lívia Moraes, Angelita Fraternity Without Borders, big hug to you, Angelita. John DeRosa, my eternal friend. Renata Casadei, how are you? Valéria Benfica, what a joy. It's good to see you here. Silvio Otero, big hug to you. Nina Dui, Paula Andrade, how are you? Hope all is well in the beautiful Tennessee, right? All right. Vanessa, you look like sun with your yellow sweat. You see, I put it on without even thinking of this, but they knew it. Isn't that amazing? It's fantastic. Thank you for the reminder. Didn't realize it until now. So, you see, the spirits, huh? They are fantastic. So, may Jesus, says Euripides Barçanufo, protect our hearts in the necessary strengthening to the true ascent. Okay? A big kiss on your heart. Let's move forward. And as he says, do not stop. Keep going. Keep going. Big hug and until tomorrow.